friends, welcome to TechnoFun KVS. Today, in continuation with LibreOffice Writer, we will learn about the various formatting options available in LibreOffice Writer. Yes, formatting options are generally used to apply over the text you write in your document. It is very helpful in making your document very beautiful, very attractive, and a very neat and clean manner. So today, we will learn about the formatting bar. As you can see on the screen, it's an image. As I click on this, can you observe the change in that formatting toolbar? Like if I click over here anywhere on the document, the one formatting toolbar is there on the top of the document, that is this one, where my mouse is currently moving on, this one. This is known as the formatting toolbar. If I click on the image, this formatting toolbar gets disappeared. The reason being, formatting toolbars options generally used on the text, not on the image. So to learn over the formatting toolbar options, let's have some text. For example, here we have a paragraph related to writer. This paragraph contains the definition of writer. So as you can see, when I clicked on the text, the formatting toolbar again get appeared over the screen. Now, one by one, we will learn about the formatting toolbar options. The very first one is set paragraph style. So right now my paragraph is the default. You can select anyone like the title, so it get converted to title and so on. So you can change any of the style of the paragraph. The next one is next paragraph option, or you can see the next formatting option is this one. This is the update selected style. This is actually used to create your own styles, but we will not learn this options right now. Right now we will learn about the formatting options. Now, the next one is font name. As we select any of the text and select over the this option, this is like the how your text will looks, how its front face that will get appeared over the printouts or the documents. For example, let's say I have selected Calibri. So see a change over the text. I'm zooming the screen so that you can see. Yes. So let's say changed it to Arial Black. So you can observe the various changes in your text. So this is the font face. The next one is the font size. Yes, you can increase as well as decrease the size of your font. The current font is 12 point. Let's say if I got selected 26, then see the change, the increase of the font from 12 point to 26 point. So in this way, you can increase or decrease your text. Let's say, for example, I have selected only this line, started from here and select this. And this one, I want 40. So see, rest of the text is of the 22 as you selected previously. And the current one is of this 40 point, and this one is of 28 point. So whenever you click over the particular area of the text, it shows you the currently applied formatting options. Now, the next one is bold, italic, underline. These are the very common options. For example, I have selected this one. Click on the bold. So see, this is bold. Actually, it's Arial Black, so it's already bold. So that's why it's not showing you the very much difference between these two. Let me show you the difference. Let's say I have selected all the text, convert it to, let's say, 13. And let's say, take the font as Calibri. So this is the current settings. Now, let's say I have selected contents, diagrams, indexes, text, click on bold. Now you can see a change in this text. This is something bold, thicker than rest of the text. So this is bold option. Now click on italic. So some tilde is there. A slanting text is there, which is the means of italic. And the underline means you can underline the selected text. So these are the bold, italic, underline. Once you click, these options get applied over the text. And again you click, these options get disappeared. So this way you can apply bold, italic, underline. Now the next one is, this is known as a strike through. You can see, observe the cutting line in between the S. So this is known as a strike through. Sometimes we need to show some text having a line cutting over here. For example, I have selected full featured word process word. Now click on this C. So this is strike through. You can create a line over the word. Now, next one is, this is something, this is known as superscript and this is known as subscript. These options are used to write the chemical reactions, the mathematical formulas, in your chapters, in your notebooks. For example, let's say I have written H2O like this. So see carefully, I have selected two. Click on the subscript. See, the two gets changed its position at the base of H. So this is the subscript option. If you want anything on the base, just like you write the dates, for example, I have written 5. See, there is a change to these options are by default set in the writer. Let's say, let's have something like, let's say we have this word. Now, I have selected ED, click on the superscript. And this gets converted to like this. So this is the superscript and subscript. Superscript means something gets shifted to the power side of anything. And the subscript means that anything shifted to the base of the previous character or line or something. So these options are known as the superscript and subscript. Now, the next one is clear direct formatting. This option is the tool which you help you to convert your text to your normal text. For example, select this. And click on this. See, all the applied formatting options, just like we have applied the 28 point, we applied over the bold, italic, underline, strike through, all options get disappeared and the text back converted into the normal text. So this is the clear formatting. It will clear all the applied formatting over your text. Next one is the font color. Yes, you can change the font color. We get back to our normal settings with the help of this undo options. Now the font color. For example, this strike through word I have selected and then click on this arrow. You get the options of the color. You can decorate your document with the help of colors, which helps you to make your document very nicely presentable. So let's say, let's select this purple color, dark purple, see. So full featured word gets converted to purple color. Now select this one and let's say selected the red color. See this. So this is the font color. The same way you can use the highlight color. Highlight means when you use the highlighter, when you highlight something in your notebooks, the same way you can highlight something in the document. For example, desktop publishing tool, a kind of word I have selected and just click on it. See, this is the highlighter. Again, when you click over the arrow, it shows you the different kind of colors over there. So many choices are there. You can also create your custom colors using this toolbar. Here are different kind of shades, RGB colors. So you can make your own color also. Next one is, yes, next one is something important. That is the alignment. Alignment of your text. For example, let's say, by default, the setting of the alignment is left alignment. There are four types of alignment in your writer. Left, center, right, and justify. Now, by default, the text is left aligned. And as you can see, at the left side of the text, all the letters are at the same indentation. Indentation means at the same position. See this. Okay, now convert. Let's select the center. See, whole text gets shifted to the center of your document. So this is the center alignment. Now click on the right. So now the right side of your text is aligned at the same position, whereas the left is the arbitrary. Next one is justified. See, in the justified alignment, both left and right side is get indented at the same position. See how beautiful it is. Clearly positioned exactly equally from left as well as from the right. So these are the four alignment options. Now, next one is, see, bulleted list, and this is number list. So sometimes we need to write the list of items. For example, let's say I have written one heading is there, fruit's name, Now I have written mango, apple, banana, for example, this. So I want to convert them into a list. So select it and click on this arrow. These symbols are known as the bullets. Bullets means whenever you prepare a list in your document or in your notebooks or something where in headings or anywhere you can use the bullet list. In those places you can use this. For example, I have selected this. See, first one is mango. Now when you click over this, these bullet lists comes on itself. ये अपने आप आती हैं, अपने आप अपनी लिस्ट को प्रिपेयर कर सकते हैं. आपको एक बार एक टेक्स्ट को सिलेक्ट करना है एंड इट विल गेट कमिंग ऑन योर लिस्ट वन बाय वन वन बाय वन वन बाय वन. नाउ लेट्स से एप्पल, नेक्स्ट वन इज बनाना एंड सो. सो इन दिस वे यू कैन क्रिएट योर ऑन लिस्ट. यू कैन ऑल्सो कन्वर्ट इट टू bulleted, these are known as the bulleted list. You can also convert it into the numbering list, like see the numbering list. So did you recall the various kind of lists you prepare in your notes when you write in your notebooks? These are the options, the number of days and something. For example, we write the number of days, weekdays, fine. So yeah, let's write weekdays. And now click on the any of the numbered option. Let's say, let's choose this one. Okay. As we are writing the number of days, let's choose numbers one. So let's say it's Sunday. As you click, two automatically get appeared on the screen. Monday, Tuesday, and so on. So this is the list. This is bulleted when your list is not in order, and this is numbered list when you have a order in your document. See, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday in order, you can't write Tuesday before the Monday. Okay, na? But in mango, apple, banana, you can write anything anywhere. So this is the difference between the bulleted and the list. Now, next one is the increase indent. Indentation means the difference, the gap between the text and the corners, the margins of your paper. For example, this is indentation. See the gap, H2O, and this gap, this gap. This is known as the indentation. If you increase, this is for the increase in indentation. For example, my cursor is here, and if I click on this, see, it gets shifted to right side. So it increases the left indentation. And if I click on it, it get shifted to left side. It means it increases the right indentation. So indentation means the gap between the edges of your paper and the text, where you started the writing the text. So this is indentation. Now, next one is the set line spacing. Line spacing means when you write a paragraph, see this paragraph, I'll show you, and click on it. So these are the different kinds of gaps between the lines. For example, if I select this, see the lines of this paragraph shattered over there. It increases the gap between the lines. Now, again, click, see. So this is the gap between the lines of a paragraph. Now this is known as a line spacing. Now increase paragraph space. If you have more than one paragraph, for example, here is one paragraph, another one is this. So if we select this and if we click on this, this will increase the paragraph spacing, the spacing between the paragraph. Line spacing increases the difference or the gap between the lines within a paragraph, and the paragraph spacing increase the difference between the between two or more paragraphs. Fine. So it will increase the difference between the paragraph. It will decrease the paragraph settings or the paragraph gap between the two paragraphs. Okay. If we select this and click on this, yes, this decreases the gap between the paragraph. So the all these options are the formatting options. You can also choose these options from the format. See, all the options are available over here also. See this. So these are the formatting toolbar. Now, one more option is there, known as the text cases. Text cases means whenever you work on the English, like in the format, there is option text, and in text you get these options like uppercase, lowercase, cycle case, sentence case, capitalized, toggle. These six cases are available in your Right. Now, for example, if I click on this, see carefully, you are free to concentrate. This is the selected text. Now, click on format, text, and click on uppercase. See, all the letters get converted to uppercase. It is very helpful option. Now, again, see the next option, lowercase. All letters converted to lowercase. So now different kind of cases are there. For example, so upper and lower, we had already know cycle case. Cycle case is used to repeat the previously used text cases. Firstly, let's show the sentence case. Sentence means whenever you write a sentence in your English, the first letter of your sentence get capital and all the other letters get small. So this is the sentence case. So see, if I select the sentence case, first letter, you are free to concentrate. This is in between the any sentence. That's why it's not get capital. If we select, for example, as you can see already, there is a, let's say if we write like this and select this, this is the sentence case. The writer gets W gets converted to capital case. This is the sentence case. Okay. Now next one was the capitalized every word. It will capital the first letter of every word of your sentence. See this? See, writer has all the features. W is capital, H is capital, A is capital, T and F. So capitalize each word means you, if you want to capital each first letter of your word, of your sentence. Now the next one is toggle. See, toggle case. Toggle, simply toggle means it converts upper to lower, lower to upper. See this. Previously, W, H, A, T, and F, these were the capital and rest were the small. Now you can see the change. All capital gets converted to small, all small gets converted to capital. So this is a toggle case. Now, see, cycle case. If I convert this cycle case, it's previously we had applied the capitalized every word over the selected case. Now see the previous one. Now again, click on the cycle case. Previous sentence case, which we had applied over the text. So cycle case means it repeats the steps by steps we apply over the text, the different kind of cases. That's the cycle case. So these were the different kinds of cases available in your writer. So hopefully these options, you like these options, apply these, write any document and apply these options. Try each and every option. These are very good and makes your document very presentable. Thank you so much.